Alright, so the other day Palkia got his grid expansion and I did do a showcase for him, but I wanted to take a look at what he can do and go up against Claire with Spacial Rend. And this is the build that I have for Palkia with Spacial Rend. I think I showed it off in my other video as well, but we'll just go over it again. So we have Spacial Rend power-ups, of course, and then we got Emotional Voice, so those are his sync move power-ups. And then we got Spacial Rend Accuracy, plus 5, and then we got Catastrophe, 2, and then we got Spacial Rend Move Gauge Refresh. So overall, like, his grid isn't really the best for Spacial Rend, but it is still very good because he does get a multiplier for his sync move, which is great. And then having Move Gauge Refresh for Spacial Rend is very good. And you could also make him a little bit more self-sufficient with his lucky skill, so you could take off Critical Strike 2 and then add in the lucky skill where every time you would get a crit, your crit would increase as well. So then you can make him self-sufficient that way, so then it can free up a spot on your team. Because right now, I have Alakazam here just because Palkia doesn't have any crit ups from his kit, unless he were to have that lucky skill on his kit. So we have Alakazam here to increase our crit. But yeah, like overall, Palkia is in the top 5 hardest hitters in the game for single target or for basic moves, like Hydro Pump, Earthquake and stuff like that. Like those regular moves, Palkia is one of the top 5 in the game. Like he hits very, very hard. And I'm happy that he got this buff because this is something that he definitely, definitely needed. And he's one of my favorite Pokemon because Sinnoh just holds a special spot in my heart. Just because of growing up, the childhood memories and everything. So it's sentimental to me as well. But overall, like, what's to say what's going to happen with future Legendary Event Pokemon? Like, we're still waiting for Solgaleo, we're still waiting for Ho-Oh, and then we got Mewtwo, which is going to be an insane one. So there's a lot, and we got future Legendary Event Pokemon to come as well. Like, we can see maybe Giratina, we can see Lunala. Like, there's so many Pokemon. I don't think they're gonna make Lunala Legendary Event just because we got Solgaleo, so then maybe they might make her a summonable one. But anyways, let's just go into the battle and see how Palkia can perform with Spacial Rend. Hopefully I changed up the grid. I think I did. I know I was on the grid, but I don't know if I hit confirmed. If I didn't, that would be pretty embarrassing. But yeah, so anyways, let's just increase everything right away. Only downside with this is that we're not going to have Mei on the team for, for healing, because like in the rain, when we have rain active and then with the water build that I have for him, he can heal up in the rain. But with Spacial Rend, I mean, you can still do that if you really want to, but it's just, yeah, you're going to have to kind of go out of your way and sacrifice some stuff for Spacial Rend. But like we can see right here, like very, very good, super effective. Like he's doing almost 4,000 damage, which is very good. And then we still got the sync move to come into play as well. Boom, 4,600 damage, very good. Definitely nothing to take lightly, that's for sure. I want to go for one. I don't know if we're gonna be able to get our sync move. We might have to have Rotom on the team instead of Alakazam, just so we can actually get our sync move. I'm gonna go for Water Pulse and just try to get our sync move off that way, but I don't think that's gonna happen because of this Unity attack. I hate the Unity attack so much. It's just so annoying, honestly. Like, why are you here? God, when you're just trying to grind up, like, cause I'm grinding coins a lot. And then when you're trying to beat it at a certain pace, like, and try to get a certain time to, just so you can have, be at an efficient time for grinding the coins, like, Unity attack just ruins your day. Like, it really ruins your day. But yeah, you know what, let's actually go and add in Rotom to the team. I should just press play again, just so we can get right back to the team, setup, but that's okay. So yeah, let's just get Rotom in here, get rid of Alakazam for now. Just so we could use Breathtaking so we can get our sync move off. Because like we have the multiplier for his grid, so like I want to get his sync move off so we can see how much we can do against Claire. And if we get super lucky, we can also get 2 Breathtakings, and then we could like get to our sync move right away, which is going to be even better. Alisa and Rotom are fun, especially with Breathtaking, because like it allows you to sync move super, super quick, which I really like a lot. And I definitely want to try to get rid of Claire as soon as possible, just because with us not being able to heal right now, we're very, very vulnerable. And they're attacking us right now. Oh, no. Please. Okay, thank you. I think we're good. Let's try to get the side Pokemon, actually, just so we can get our sick move, Spacial Rend there, 3,900 damage, very nice. And then we're going to get rid of Salamence here, and then we'll be able to sync move. And I think the sync move should be able to knock out Claire. Oh, wow, it didn't even knock her out, or Salamence out. Okay, anyway, let's just go for the sync move against Claire. Damn it, I swear, man, this Unity attack is just so annoying. I hate it so much. Get rid of it, Dina. Get rid of it, please. If they don't want to get rid of it, at least give us an option if we want to skip it, like, in a way to make it, like, balanced, because 11,000 damage, not bad. Not bad at all. Like I was saying, for, like, co-op with Unity Attack, players can choose if they want to skip the Unity Attack or not. Like, at the beginning of battle, like, it can give up, like, a little indicator, like, saying, do you want to skip Unity Attack or something? And then if a majority of the players press yes, then there's going to be no Unity Attack. But at the same time, it's part of the mechanic in co-op, so I don't know, I guess they can keep it. It just bugs me, personally, but I guess it is what it is. But yeah, let's do this again and see Palkia's Spacial Rend. And then we'll go into another stage and see what he can do, what is not super effective with Spacial Rend. And I'm sure it's still going to be a lot of damage, just because, like, with Critical Strike 9 and then plus another Critical Strike 2 on his Lucky skill, he's able to do a lot of damage with that multiplier from Critical Strike. And that's definitely nothing to take lightly, that's for sure. And I do like the animation with Spacial Rend. It's nice. I do really, really like it. Again, like, I'm a little bit biased with Palkia just because I have a special attachment with the Sinnoh region. So Palkia is just awesome for me. And I'm just so happy. Obviously, Hydro Pump is the better build for... for Palkia, because of the multiplier, with ramming speed, with Hydro Pump, the damage Hydro Pump is already able to do, like, it's just so, so good. But yeah, this is actually annoying now. We're paralyzed and we're not able to attack. Hopefully we can get a move gauge refresh just so we can get to, yeah, you know what, okay, we're just gonna end it. So I'll see you guys in the next battle. Alright, so now we're going up against Janine. I wanted to go up against someone that's not super effective, or that we're not super effective against, like I said. Because you're not always going to be taking certain Pokemon into stages where you do have the type advantage, because maybe you want to have a little bit more of a challenge, or you just have a certain favorite Pokemon that you just want to use all the time. And I changed up the team a little bit. So instead of Altaria, I brought Alakazam in here just so we can get our crits up again. Because with Alisa, like, it's a gamble. Like, if you get MP refresh on Breathtaking, then you're going to be a plus 2 critical hit. But also you can get unlucky and only get one Breathtaking, which would suck, obviously. So I brought Alakazam for that reason. So now we're at max crit, which is nice. And then we're going to heal up a little bit now too, just so, we're not going to die like super easily like that, but we should be fine. So with the crit, we're doing like 1,100 damage, 1,600. Very nice. Like, actually, he's not bad. Obviously, Hydro Pump is a lot better, but we're just taking a look at Spacial Rend, because in the actual showcase video, we mainly looked at Hydro Pump in co-op. So I just wanted to do Spacial Rend in co-op and see what he can do when he's not super effective as well. But like, with the multiplier that he gets from his sync move, like, the damage that he does after critting is gonna be good. It's gonna be good, I would imagine. Like, we know when he's super effective, like, he's good, he's very strong. Especially with Hydro Pump, but his sync move when he's not super effective, I'm curious to see what he's gonna do. So here we go. And his sync move is like almost a guaranteed crit, I think, which is nice. So 5,000 damage, not bad. So now that we got a sync move buff, we're gonna be hitting harder, so this is gonna be cool. Damn it, these sync moves. These Unity attacks. I swear, I cannot escape them, but I guess in this situation, I'm fine with it, just because, yeah, we're not super effective, so this could help us. So here we go, our last Spacial Rend, and this does 2,400 damage, not super effective, so not bad, not bad. It takes time to build up, but once you get built up with your attack and everything, this guy, Palkia, Cyrus, they're gonna be very strong. That Critical Strike 9 is no joke. In the future, when we do get to the level cap of 140, all Pokemon are going to be hitting much harder, and then Pokemon with multipliers, they're going to be hitting even harder, because multipliers are just another level, compared to, like, flat number boost. But Palkia with Spacial Rend, super, super good when he's super effective, and when he's not super effective, he's still good, but there's better Pokemon that, that can hit harder when he's not super effective. But again, like I said, I already showcased Hydro Pump in my last video, so I wanted to do Spacial Rend and just sort of showcase it and have a video around Spacial Rend when we're super effective and when we're not super effective. Because we're getting Cyrus and Hydreigon tomorrow, so I guess it could be like dragon themed. but yeah, this is another showcase for Palkia, but just with Spacial Rend. Let me know what you guys think of them. What build do you like better? Do you like the Spacial Rend build? Do you like the Hydro Pump build? Hell, like, do you even like the Water Pulse build? You got three builds that you can do, which is nice. And with the grid update, now we can have up to like four different builds, which is nice. So yeah, let me know what build you like the most. Me personally, as much as Hydro Pump is very good, I have a lot more fun with Spacial Rend. Because if you really want to get self-sufficient, you could add in that lucky skill where every time you get a crit, your crit chance would get higher. Like, you'd build up your crit over time and then making them self-sufficient. So then you don't have to worry about that, because Spacial Rend has a good chance of giving you a crit and then a sync move. So, like, once you do those, and then you get lucky with Spacial Rend, like, you could be a +3 critical hit. And then you don't have to worry about having support on the team to buff your crit chances, which is nice. So you could go that way as well if you want. You're going to be sacrificing two Critical Strike, or Critical Strike 2, but at the same time, he does have Critical Strike 9, and that is more than enough, too, especially if you're being self-sufficient. It adds another spot on the team that you could add for more damage or more support in terms of healing or whatever. So, overall, Palkia is very fun, and I'm super, super glad they gave him this buff and this treatment. It would have sucked if they didn't do anything good, but at the same time, just adding move gauge refreshes would have been plenty as well, because then we don't have to worry about move gauge issues. But that's gonna be it for this video. Again, let me know what build you like the most with Palkia. Hydro Pump is a fun build, it's very strong, but me personally, I like the Spacial Rend build the most. That's my personal opinion. But that's gonna be it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later.